How would you feel if the medicine you are taking has a warning label that tells you it can lead you to death? And how would you feel if you keep getting confused with the many, many different medicines that you have to take? And what would you do if you discovered that your medicine would work more effectively when it's taken together with something else? For many years, people living with asthma had to deal with these problems because of their medication. There was a warning label, there were multiple medicines, and there were drug combinations that had to be decided. Hi, I am Dr. Charles Edward Florendo, author of the book Secrets to Effective Holistic Asthma Care. Today, I will tell you an interesting story on why your popular asthma inhalers come with a steroid. This is the top 3 reasons why your asthma inhalers come with a steroid. And number 1 might shock you. Did you know that people have inhaled substances to treat asthma symptoms for at least 3,500 years? From smoking opium in ancient China to breathing in fumes of burning herbs in ancient Greece, people have been looking for ways to cure their asthma by breathing in different kinds of substances. The first known reference to this type is an ancient Egyptian papyrus scroll that documented people inhaling the vapor of the black henbane plant, or stinking nightshade. From the name of this plant alone, I'm sure that this plant truly stinks. Now, if I was to smell or inhale something that smelled so bad, wouldn't I just pretend my asthma was getting better? Well, maybe that's how it worked. No, but seriously, now this document mentioned that this plant was placed on hot bricks, then covered with a jar with a hole in it. People breathed in the vapor through a hole using a reed stalk. Later on, an English physician named John Mudge created the first inhaler in 1778, and this was called the Mudge inhaler. To operate this inhaler, you would need to pour water into the tankard, close the lid, and breathe in the steam through the flexible tube inserted into an opening in the cover. It still kind of sounds like the way Egyptians did it, doesn't it? Yes, because you still needed a source of heat. In 1858, the first portable nebulizer was invented by Dr. Salles Girons, and this was called the Pulverisateur. It had a pump handle which was like a bicycle pump, and it drew solution from the reservoir and forced it through an atomizer. This is kind of closer to our modern-day nebulizers today. This eventually made way to nebulizers with squeeze bulbs. In 1956, the 13-year-old daughter of Georges Masson, who was president of Riker Laboratories, complained that she was tired of her squeeze bulb nebulizer, and she asked, "Why can't you just spray the medicine out of a bottle like my perfume?" This question led Masson to create the first convenient portable device that effectively delivered medicine to the lungs. This was marketed in 1956 by Riker Laboratories with a tagline, "Nothing is quicker, nothing is more effective." And yes, it was quick and it was effective, and in fact, for the past 70 years, the basic design of this inhaler has not changed. So, we owe the invention of our modern inhalers to a 13-year-old complaining girl. Since then, various types of medicines have been tried on these inhalers to see which ones will work best against asthma. Currently, the mainstay of asthma treatment now revolves around the use of inhaled bronchodilators. Bronchodilators are medicines that will relax the muscles around your airways to open them up and relieve you of your asthma. We can classify bronchodilators into two kinds. There's the short-acting ones, such as salbutamol, and the long-acting ones, such as salmeterol and formeterol. Now, if you look closely, you will see that the long-acting ones, such as salmeterol and formeterol, is always sold with a steroid combined with them. Have you ever wondered why? Well, here are the top 3 reasons why steroids always come with long-acting asthma medicines. Number 3. Steroids are an effective add-on to asthma medicines. Yes, steroids are naturally produced by your body to control inflammation, among other things. Unfortunately, for people living with asthma, they suffer from having abnormal steroid levels in their blood. These abnormal steroid levels is one of the reasons why their asthma easily get triggered by various things around them. Medical steroids help to supplement these abnormal steroid levels. Unfortunately, still, medical steroids are not exactly the same as their natural counterparts. And so, these medical steroids can cause a variety of unwanted side effects as well. Number 2. Combining steroids with your bronchodilators helps improve compliance. If you have to take 2 or more medicines separately, it would be very confusing and it would be easy for you to forget or easily confuse one or the other medicine. After you take one, you might ask, "Did I take the other one already?" Combining your medicines in a single package is a convenient way to ensure that people take their medicines more religiously. In fact, there are many studies now that are showing that combining medicines into a single pill or inhaler ensures that people take their medicines properly. So, I have been seeing a very popular trend that more and more medicines have been coming in combination tablets or pills. Finally, we have the number 1 reason why salmeterol or formeterol medicines come with steroids, and this might shock you. Remember that warning label I talked about? Well, yes, the biggest reason why these medicines come with steroids is because some people who just use plain salmeterol or fluticasone without their steroids died earlier than those who did not even take these medicines. Yes, as shocking as it seems, in November 2005, the United States Food and Drug Administration released a health advisory alerting the public to findings that show the use of long-acting beta-2 agonists such as salmeterol and formeterol could lead to a worsening of symptoms and, in some cases, even death. This was supported in 2006 by a study done by Cornell and Stanford University researchers, which linked common asthma inhalers to up to 80% of asthma-related deaths. I know, 80%! Isn't that crazy? That's like 8 out of every 10 people. So, for some time, these two medicines were required by the US FDA to have printed warning labels on their boxes, warning consumers of the danger of death by using these medicines. When drug companies began to ship these medicines along with steroids, the risks associated with them declined. And since then, the US FDA had allowed drug manufacturers to remove this warning label. Now, did you know that beyond just inhaling medicines, a big factor you might want to look at is how you actually inhale the air you breathe? Yes, asthma treatment guidelines around the world have kept mentioning the use of breathing exercises to improve asthma control. Many of my students have successfully used a system utilizing breathing control to help them control their asthma. This system helps your body produce more steroids and bronchodilators naturally without the use of any medicines. The best studied system to do this was developed by a Russian physician named Dr. Konstantin Buteyko. And his technique has helped thousands of people around the world, including hundreds of my students, control their asthma in a way that is free from drug-induced side effects. Now, if you would like to know more about this amazing method, I have included a link in the description of this video which will tell you when my next talk will be. So please visit this link and register so that you can get the links to my free talks on this subject. Also, I'd like to know more about what you experienced taking these medicines. What do you think about these medicines? Have they become safe just because they were added to a steroid? Please add your comments down below. I'd love to hear your comments. I am Dr. Charles Edward Sorrento, medical advisor to the world's leading authority on the Buteyko method. So I'd love to read your comments below. Oh, and if you enjoyed this video, I would really appreciate it if you click on the subscribe button and ring that bell so you can get more of my contents every time it comes out. I'll see you soon.